What's up, guys? Brian, Colorado Camper Man here. So in today's video, I'm gonna talk about a very heated topic, and that is gas versus diesel trucks. I wanted to give you guys my perspective of towing our travel trailer between our old 2005 Dodge Ram 3500 with the 5.9 liter Cummins turbo diesel versus our 2019 Chevy Silverado 2500 with the 6 liter gas engine. So, couple of disclaimers before we get started. First disclaimer is, let's keep it clean in the comment section. Really my hope and goal as to why I'm doing this video is to help give people my perspective with my experience in case you're somebody that's looking to make the decision between a gas truck and a diesel truck and you don't know which way to go. My hope is that this video may be able to help you. I did do a video that talked about 10 reasons why we switched from diesel to gas, but this is gonna be more of a comparison as far as the differences that I've noticed of towing our travel trailer with the diesel engine and the gas engine. So we've towed our travel trailer actually with one diesel truck, and then I have actually towed our travel trailer with 4 gas trucks in total. But I'm gonna be specifically focusing on this 2019 Chevy Silverado and our old 05 Dodge Ram 3500. So I'm gonna flash the specs of the Dodge Ram 3500 because I can't remember exactly the torque and the horsepower and the gear ratio and all that stuff, but it was a 4-speed automatic transmission. It was a crew cab long bed. I want to say that the payload capacity on that truck was somewhere around 2600 pounds or so. The curb weight was 7200-ish, something like that, and the GVWR was like 9,900 pounds. And now we're gonna be comparing that to this 2019 Chevy Silverado 2500 HD, again with the 6 liter V8 engine. And I, again, will put all the specs, so don't misquote myself here as far as horsepower, torque, all that stuff. I know we do have a payload capacity of 2842. That is after you take into consideration gas. So this truck actually has a higher payload capacity than our previous truck. And again, this is a crew cab long bed as well. All right, guys, so I'm gonna give you guys 5 comparisons of towing with our old diesel truck versus our new truck here. So the first comparison that I wanna talk about is off the line acceleration. So let's say you're going up to a stoplight. From my experience, what's better, the diesel or the gasser? Well, I would say that this gasser actually has better off the line acceleration while towing. This truck does have more horsepower than our old Dodge. Our previous Dodge, it would get up pretty good, but the problem is with a turbo truck, it takes a couple seconds for the turbo to really kick in. And our old Dodge, if I were to, you know, punch it, and I were to punch this gas truck, this gasser would beat it off the line for sure. Now, once the turbo would kick in on the diesel, then it might catch up, but I personally think that this truck would probably be so far ahead, I think it would actually, the diesel would end up kind of struggling to get up. So I would definitely give the off-the-line acceleration to this gas truck. So the second comparison that I want to talk about is getting up to speed. So my experience from, you know, getting on the interstate, say I was on the on-ramp and I punched it, I had the gas truck and the diesel truck, which one would be better? Well, as I had mentioned in the first comparison, this truck definitely has I feel like the off-the-line acceleration is really good. However, with the diesel and the turbo, once that kicks in, if you were to punch it and you were trying to get up to like an interstate speed of say 75, the diesel would end up catching up over a longer stretch for sure. And so it's hard for me to say which one is better, because the Chevy, again, the straight off the line, really good. So the diesel, when that turbo kicks in, man, I mean, it takes it to a whole nother level. And especially when you have a longer stretch like that, I think it'd be pretty close. Maybe the diesel be, you know, give the nudge to the diesel, but it'd be pretty darn close for sure. The third comparison that I want to talk about is once you're up to speed, or once I was up to speed, actually being able to pass somebody. So let's say I was going on the interstate, I was going 75 miles an hour, that's the speed limit here, and I had a slow poke in front of me and I wanted to pass them. What would be better, the diesel or this gas truck? That one, I would definitely give to the Dodge, the diesel. For whatever reason, that truck always seemed to have had an extra gear, even though it was a 4-speed, and this truck has a 6-speed transmission. For whatever reason, that diesel always seemed to have an extra gear, and I could punch it on the interstate, and I could be, you know, I could go 85, 90 pulling our travel trailer, no problem. This truck, while it is good passing people, it's not as good as our diesel was for sure. Now, if I were to, you know, shift into manual mode, you know, while going 75 or whatever, and I downshift, then maybe this truck would be as good. But if I was just in like the regular tow haul, it's no comparison. I'd say that the old Dodge with the diesel definitely had the edge. So the fourth comparison that I want to talk about is driving over hills. Now, I've lived in Colorado my entire life, and I've heard people tell me that, you know, what we would consider hills here in Colorado are like mountains elsewhere. And so I have been out of state. I've been to a lot of states. So, but I don't have a whole lot of comparison, because I've never driven our travel trailer out of state. I've only ever actually driven it in Colorado. I would say that the diesel, hands down, is better in this aspect, especially on steeper grades. Now, if you're going up just like a pretty mellow hill, you know, maybe a 2-4% grade, something like that, and you're not at high elevation, then I don't think there's as big of a difference between our old diesel and the gas truck, especially since this truck has a 6-speed transmission. You know, I'm able to go up hills really good. But man, once you get up to those super steep grades or do some high elevation mountains, our old diesel would just chug up hills. If you guys have seen the Fastlane truck on YouTube, what they do is they try towing loads up what they call the Ike Gauntlet. And the Ike Gauntlet is going from Silverthorne, Colorado, which is at like 9,800 feet, up to the Eisenhower Tunnel, which I think is at like 11,500. So it's over the course of 7-8 miles, and it's a 7% grade. So not only are you dealing with a very steep grade, but you also have the elevation involved as well too. And if you look at that, they tow huge loads, and they max out these trucks, and the diesels are always faster than the gassers. And in my experience, I would definitely agree with that for sure. I've actually driven the Ike Gauntlet with our old Dodge, and it did fantastic. I have not driven the Ike Gauntlet with this truck yet, but I have driven some of the mountain passes with this truck that I did with my old truck, and the diesel definitely did better for sure. So the fifth and final comparison that I want to talk about is actually doing mountain driving. So we just talked about the hills and whatnot as far as the big difference there, but I want to just talk about mountain driving, because a lot of people say that you know, gas engines will not do as good at higher elevations because of the lack of oxygen and whatnot. And again, I'm referring more to Colorado because, like, we live at 4,700 feet elevation, and a couple weeks ago we camped near Leadville and it was at 10,300 feet. Now, our drive for that trip, we obviously have this truck, but for that drive, you know, yes, we did go up 5,500 feet, 5,600 feet in elevation, but it was over the course of about 100 miles. So this truck did just fine. Now, if we were to go up I-25 to I-70, where, you know, we're going from 5,280 feet up to 11,500 feet, yeah, the diesel definitely has the edge for sure, kind of like we talked about in the last main comparison. But if you're just talking about general, you know, driving around the mountains, not doing any crazy passes, stuff like that, in my experience, not a huge difference between our old diesel and this gas truck. All right, guys, well, that pretty much does it for this video. So hopefully it didn't get too heated or upset too many people. You know, overall, the main differences that we've noticed difference while towing is really hills and steep hills. I'm talking mountain passes. That is really the largest area that we have noticed a difference between our old diesel truck and this 2019 Chevy gas truck. And in all honesty too, it's not a big enough difference for me to want to go get a diesel again. This truck does just fine. If I was concerned about making it to my destination, you know, 5 or 10 minutes faster, then maybe I'd go with a diesel. But, you know, overall with our setup, with, like I said, maybe towing 8,500 pounds between what's in the bed of the truck and our actual trailer, this truck does just fine. So if I was going to be towing like a fifth wheel that was, you know, 12,000 pounds and up, then I'd probably go with the diesel truck. Because then it would just do a lot better for sure. But for what we tow, gas truck is fine. So if you guys are in a similar situation where you're going to be towing, you know, similar size load, maybe consider a gas truck. It'll save you a lot of money and, you know, should be able to take care of all your towing needs. So, but if you're going to be towing something a lot heavier, or you're going over a ton of mountain passes and, you know, you just want to be able to rocket up those passes, go with the diesel. But that's just from my experience. So what's your guys' experience been? Have you guys gone from a diesel to a gas truck? Put in the comments below if you guys have any two cents. So, and again, let's keep it clean, please. So, but I'll put a link to the video that I did, 10 reasons why we went from a diesel to a gas truck. That may, again, kind of help some of you guys who are facing that same decision. But otherwise, thank you guys for checking out this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.